What are the different types of scholarships for MS in US? Am I eligible for scholarships? How can I apply for my scholarships for my masters? Are these just some of the questions running through your mind? Well, you have expert answers coming your way in 3, 2, 1. Drishti Sengupta. Today we're going to be tackling one of the biggest things when it comes to pursuing your masters. That's right, we're going to be talking about scholarships. We're here to make sure that you get the most accurate information with proven examples. At GREH, we've helped around 5,000 plus students with their dream admissions journey. Speaking only about our fall 2018 admissions alumni, they've in fact received scholarships worth ₹34.3 crores. So coming to scholarships, we've heard this word a lot, but what exactly does it mean? Scholarships are often used interchangeably with funding, which is a way to finance your MS dream. In this video today, we'll be speaking about the various types of scholarships, when to apply, how to apply, and the key steps you can take to ensure you have the best chance of getting a scholarship. We've also included an ebook in the description box below so that you can get all the information about scholarships possible. It also has a list of external organizations offering scholarships so that you can get all the help you need. So before we jump into scholarship, let's first understand what financing your master's comprises of. There are two expenses that you will face: living costs and tuition fee. Your tuition fee is dependent on which university you're choosing to pursue your master's in. Your living costs will of course depend on which state you choose to live to pursue your master's. If you're living in the state of Texas, expect some kind of expense around the $500 mark or so. But if you're living in the state of New York, your expenses can range from $800 to even up to $1,200 a month. So how are scholarships used? Well, most of the funding that you get from your scholarships is in fact used to cover your tuition fee. Now let's take a look at the various types of scholarships available. First up on our list, tuition fee waivers. When it comes to tuition fee waivers, simply you get to study for free. Or a part of your tuition fee is in fact waived off, meaning you don't have to pay it at all. To get more clarity, let's look at a sample profile from the long list of students that have received successful admits with scholarships from our GREH Wall of Fame. Here we have an example of Debashish Parida, who received a tuition fee waiver worth $20,000 from Rochester Institute of Technology. He had a 316 in his GRE, a 98 in his TOEFL, and a GPA of 8. He's pursuing his master's in chemical engineering. Besides that, speaking about his profile, he had 2 research papers and also 2 internships, but no work experience. Here's an example of Sujita, who got not one, but 2 tuition fee waivers. One from TAMU worth $14,000 and the second from UT Dallas worth $50,000. She has a 321 in GRE, a 7.5 in her IELTS, and a GPA of 8. She's pursuing her master's in Management Information Systems. She had no internships or work experience on her profile, but she had some research work and a couple of projects on her profile. Overall, the major thumb rule is to apply for a tuition fee waiver, have a good GRE score, have a great TOEFL score, and definitely good academics as well. But this does vary from profile to profile because everyone has different set of work experience, projects, research papers, or internships. If you're wondering, what are the other types of profiles that can get scholarships? Well, we're launching a video very soon, so stay tuned and check out that video. Speaking about how to apply for a tuition fee waiver, well, it doesn't differ from your normal online application process. For some universities, they may specify you to fill out a separate scholarship form and submit it alongside your online application. Second on our list, assistantships. Assistantships basically mean that you work under a department or a faculty and do some particular tasks related to the kind of assistantship you've chosen. There are mainly 3 types of assistantships: graduate assistantships, research assistantships, and teaching assistantships. If you're a graduate assistant, you can expect your role to be very diverse. Expect interacting with a lot of international students and even working with faculties from different departments. An example of this would be working at the International Relations Office of your university. If you're working as a research assistant, you will be helping out a professor in their research work. Expect opportunities to write your own research proposals, measure progress of research, analyze and identify exactly the various parameters of the research, and report all the findings as well. If you're a teaching assistant, you can expect your job role to be similar to what a professor does at the university. This could be teaching undergraduate courses, mentoring other students or clearing their doubts, or even conducting examinations. Here is an example of Shantanu Kumar. He had a GPA of 7 with 7 backlogs. Besides that, he had a 314 in his GRE and a 104 in his TOEFL exam. He had no work experience or paper publications, but he had a few internships on his profile. So what makes it a scholarship? Well, in return for 15 to 20 hours a week of work, you receive a stipend in return. This stipend can range between $1,800 to $2,000 per month. In some cases, for the assistantship that you do, you receive credits in return for your course. For example, Sunny Stony Brook offers this very same facility to their students. If you want to be selected for an assistantship, work on your profile. That means good academics, good GPA, and overall a very strong GRE and TOEFL score as well. Try targeting 100 plus in your TOEFL or a 7 plus band score in your IELTS as well. The most probable time for students to get assistantships is when they enroll at the university and after their first semester of study. Besides that, you can even approach the professor that you want to work under and request for an assistantship as well. Research about the universities and the faculty to include it in your statement of purpose. This displays that you have done your research and truly want to get into that university with a very deep interest in it. Thus, your chances of getting an admit will also be higher. Learn how to write a compelling statement of purpose with pro tips and samples as well. We've included an ebook with the link in the description box below. Download it now. So those were the most popular types of funding. Of course, there are other options, for example, fellowships, but these aren't easily accessible for international students, mostly being restricted for in-state or American citizens. Other popular fellowships, such as the Fulbright Nehru Fellowship, are often given to students who are pursuing a very specific course, for example, urban and regional planning or women or gender studies. Lastly, we're going to be speaking about on-campus jobs. Although they're not a type of scholarships, they're still a great way to make some extra money to fund your masters. There are many on-campus jobs that are available for students. These could range from working as a barista, at a cafe, or even working at the library at your university. You can work up to 20 hours a week during semester and during the breaks around 40 hours a week as well. You can expect a minimum wage of around $8 per hour, and the average usually is around $13 to $14 per hour. Besides that, you can find these jobs with various postings on notice boards or on the university website portals. For example, Carnegie Mellon University has a portal known as Handshake. Over there, students can register and get informed every time there's an opening on campus. So now you know all the various types of funding or scholarships available to you. But the burning question is, when and how should you apply for a scholarship? Let's take a look at 5 key steps that you can follow to make sure you have the best chance of getting a scholarship. Number 1, applying before your priority deadlines. Most universities have 2 sets of deadlines, one being the regular deadlines and one being your priority deadlines. Your priority deadlines are always earlier than your regular deadlines. Why exactly do they have priority deadlines? Well, if an applicant applies before the priority deadlines, they have a better chance of getting evaluated not only for an admit but also for scholarship. Get a great TOEFL or IELTS score. For international applicants especially, having a good English proficiency exam score is very important. Make sure you aim for 100 plus in your TOEFL or a 7 plus band score in your IELTS. Smart university shortlisting. Research exactly how much funding the university receives, and besides that, what the research profile is of the faculty as well. This solves 2 things. First, you know exactly how much scholarship funding you can expect when you apply to that university, And besides that, you can create a better match for your research profile with the one that the faculty has as well. Overall, all of these factors will ensure that you have the best chance of getting not only an admit but also a scholarship. Make a strong statement of purpose or a scholarship essay. When it comes to highlighting your profile, your statement of purpose or your scholarship essays are the best documents that you can get. So ensure you highlight the best aspects of your profile and mention exactly why you deserve the scholarship the most. Have a document checklist. There are various kinds of scholarships that are available. So when it comes to your online application process, there are other documents that you will need to submit alongside your application. For example, if you're applying for a need-based scholarship, there are certain bank documents that verify your financial background. So make sure you have all of this ready to go before you start your application process. Those were the key steps that you can take to make sure you have the best shot at getting a scholarship. And that's a wrap. We hope you found some useful tips in this video. If you want to go ahead and get started and grab yourself a scholarship, well, we've included a detailed ebook on scholarships, the various types, the various organizations you can get it from, and the application process as well. You can download it by clicking on the link in the description box below. If you like this video, don't forget to hit the subscribe button so that you get notified every time we post. Until then, this is Drishti signing off. Apply wisely.